Hey guys, it's Pasty Boy here. Today I'm going to be putting up some fencing at the garden to support the peas, and I'm going to try the cucumbers, and then something I never trellised before, but I'm going to give it a shot, is the butternut squash, because they get quite lengthy and tend to make their way outside the garden, so I'm going to try to make them climb and go across some fencing. So I've got some stuff here. Let me show you what I bought. All right, I bought a bunch of these 4-foot posts. So I've got the 3-foot wire here. So here's a current shot of the status of the garden here. Peas in the distance there are coming up. They're about at least a foot tall. This end are the butternut squash. So I think I'm gonna put a row of fencing there, try to get them to climb and hang maybe. Then at the very end here, there are the cucumbers. There, you can see I already got a post here and a post at that end. But if I wanna get the peas involved here, I'm gonna have to put a few more in and then put some over there. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm gonna start over at the side where the butternut squash are. Now I'm going to measure that and see how much wire I need to put up there. Okay, so I guess they call this welded wire. 36 inch by 50 foot roll, 2 inch by 4 inch mesh. It's 14 gauge welded wire. I guess I could have got it a little straighter, but it's kind of tough. The ground is really soft with all the rain we got. And I'm just trying to keep it, you know, in the ground. It's not crucial by any means, but I think it looks halfway decent. I kind of tried a stupid way here of weaving it in and out to keep the ends in. Probably not the best way to do it. I don't even think I'm going to clip this excess off, because, you know, if the plant starts coming to the left, it'll have some way to start climbing. And, yeah, so that's about 15 feet there. So I'm going to give that a shot once the butternut squash start taking off. Next, we're going to try to attempt to get that row in down there behind the peas and the cucumbers if it doesn't start raining. Well, that's the end of today's work. It's raining, so I won't be able to get the side here with the peas and cucumbers in today, but tomorrow's another day, so we'll pick this up then. Hey, real quickly, while I'm out here in the shed getting out of the rain, I'll show you. These are all the garden stakes that I ripped up here. These were 2x4s that I got for free, and ripped them all up. I got over about 110 pieces, and some of them I just, my miter saw cut a point on them, and some I actually went and did a four-sided point on, you know. So if they were a little bit thicker, I did a four-point. So I've got bamboo on the center of each tomato plant, and then I'm going to surround it with these. Most of it's just pine, but it was free, and, you know, I'll take it. So that's what I'm going to try this year. It's, you know, instead of buying a whole bunch of more bamboo. All right, so the rain calmed down enough. I got the three more posts in, so now I got five down this span here. Just gonna lay it out here. I'm gonna get the wire down at that end, roll it out, and see how much we need. And I pushed the peas off this side of the fence too. I'll stand them back up once I get the fence in place. Alright, it's kind of rough putting it in alone here. Had to put it over top of the other fence, which was a pain in the butt. And then trying to get it kind of lining up with all the other, you know, pieces. It was a little challenging. You know, cut myself a couple times. But I think what I'm going to do to finish it up is I'm just going to get some zip ties and zip tie it around the posts. Let me go get some zip ties. It's still kind of raining out, so can't really exactly get much footage outdoors here. All right, sun's coming out a little bit. Went and grabbed the cable ties here. These are the ones. So they're just regular 8-inchers. Probably a lot longer than I need, but it's what I have. That's what I'm using. All right, the sun's out now, but it looks like it wants to rain again. Gonna be like that on and off all day, but I think I pretty much got it done. Probably should have connected these two, but I guess if I really needed to, I could just add a little piece in there later. Kind of trying to get that cucumber plant trained to the end of this fence. It's got a cucumber on it already, so if we can get it on this trellis, we can train it to go that direction forward. Peas are going to have to come back up with the sun, and then they'll just start figuring out on their own that the fence is there and climb it. Cucumbers, I kind of leaned up against here best I could, and they'll take their own way too. So I guess that's what we can do. Put some zip ties in strategic places in order to keep it attached firmly. This was probably the best one that lined up. I was able to get, you know, this one here, that one there, you know, attached nice. But I still added a few zip ties anyway. And think this is going to do the trick. I just hope that the space between the garden fence and this trellis fence doesn't mess things up for me here for, you know, stuff getting trapped in between. I guess we'll live and learn. I could have put these posts behind the cucumbers, but then it wouldn't have lined up with the peas. So, whatever. I'll figure it out as I go. Worst case scenario, I could always, you know, pull this post out and move it forward. So, take a day at a time. There we have it. So, that's it there, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. Have a good day. Take care.